हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। हियर मायसेल्फ मिस्टर जयसवाल किशन, सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, एंड वी आर लर्निंग ऑल अबाउट स्ट्रक्चरल एनालिसिस। नाउ टुडे वी आर इन सेशन नंबर 2 ऑफ मोमेंट डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मेथड, एंड टुडे वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग विद एन एग्जाम्पल। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। नाउ हियर देर आर सम कैटेगरीज ऑफ एग्जाम्पल्स: बीम्स विदाउट सिंकिंग, फ्रेम विदाउट स्वे, फ्रेम विद स्वे, एंड टू स्पान फ्रेम। Generally, we have learnt beam using moment distribution method in previous session of structural analysis. Now, in this session of structural analysis, we will be considering frames only. But before starting to the frame, we will be taking one beam example for a reference. So let's start our first example. Now here, it is written that analyze the beam by moment distribution method and draw bending moment diagram. Now here, we have to use moment distribution method. Here a diagram is given in which A, B and C supports are my simple support, in the sense pin support. Now for AB span, it is 4 meter and having single eye and considering a central point load of 40 kN. For BC span, a UDL is given for 20 kN per meter of length 6 meter span and having 2 eye. So let's start our first step. So first step is fixed end moment. The same formula we will use, which we were using in slope deflection method, having this kind of formula for point load and for UDL. Now let's see for point load. Because AB span is having a central point load, so we have to take a point load formula. And for BC span, it is a UDL, so we have to consider a formula of UDL. Now MFAB means fixed end moment of AB span from A to B. MFAB means A to B. So for at A, it is minus WL by 8 because it is anticlockwise. So W is 40 kN into 4 is my length divided by 8 as per formula. After calculating or solving in calculator, we can get the value is minus 20 kN into meter. Similarly, for MFBA, over here it will be clockwise. So clockwise we have to take as a positive, equals to 40 into 4 upon 8 will be 20 kN into meter. Now for UDL, the formula will be WL square by 12. At B point it will be minus and at C point it will be plus. So our W is 20 kN per meter, length is 6, so its square is 36, and divided by 12, after solving in calculator will be getting minus 60 kN into meter as a fixed end moment for MFBC. And for MFCB equals to 60 kN in meter in positive. So this was our first step, which is most common in slope deflection method also and in this moment distribution method also. Now let's move ahead with the second number of step. Now before starting this second number step distribution factor, I would like to recall this formulas which we did in previous session of MDM. Now here far end is fixed, so K will be 4EI upon L. If far end is simple, means opposite end is simple, then 3EI upon L, K stiffness value we have to consider. Now here also one written that consider an internal hinge as a fix. Now if external support is a fixed support, so distribution factor for it is 0, and if external support is a hinge support, then its distribution factor is 1. This all we will be using in step number 2. Our step number 2 is distribution factor, which is K upon summation of K, means stiffness of that particular member to the entire stiffness of the structure. Now to solve this, we have to form a table. So how to form? Let's see. First of all, we have to write SR, then joint, then member which is connected to that particular joint, and then we have to find the individual stiffness, and then we have to sum up with the entire stiffness of that particular joint, and then at last distribution factor, which is using this formula. Now let's start how to form this table and how to place the value. I will explain. Let's see. First, SR1. Now why I have written B? It is coming A first, then B, then C, but we have taken as a B. Now distribution factor table, we have to form. The first basic rule is, first you have to put the center support, means the support which is coming in the middle of two support. Start with that and then you can proceed. It is a just for a simple of the solution of the example. So we have taken a B because बी मेंबर इज कनेक्टेड टू ए एंड बी मेंबर इज कनेक्टेड टू सी, मींस बी जॉइंट इज कनेक्टेड टू बी टू ए एंड बी जॉइंट इज कनेक्टेड टू बी टू सी, मींस आई एम हैविंग मेंबर ऑफ बी ए एंड हैविंग मेंबर ऑफ बी सी. सो लुक, जॉइंट बी मेंबर इट इज कनेक्टेड टू बी ए एंड मेंबर इट इज कनेक्टेड टू बी सी. नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द फर्दर स्टिफनेस. नाउ एज आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड ओवर हियर दैट फार एंड इज सिंपल, द के विल बी 3a अपॉन l. सो इफ स्टैंडिंग ओवर हियर, नाउ फर्स्ट इज माई बी ए मेंबर, इफ यू स्टैंड ओवर बी and looking towards the A, it is a simple support. So the formula will be applicable is 3i upon n. Now here we have to see how much I is given, single I. So 3 multiplied by 1 ei upon l is nothing but my 4. So after solving this, I will be getting 0.75 ei. 3 by 4 is nothing but 0.75 ei. Similarly for BC span, B to C, you can see it is a far and is simple. So 3i upon l is a formula, but here 2i is given, so we have to multiply 3 multiplied by 2 into ei upon 6. Ultimately, it is 1 ei. So this is my particular individual stiffness of that particular member, BA member and BC member. So after finding this, we have to sum up that for using in distribution factor formula that we required a summation of stiffness. Now, summation of stiffness will be 1 plus 0.75 is nothing but 1.75. And then after applying a formula k upon summation of k means 0.75 ei upon 1.75 ei. So ei ei will be cancelled out. 0.75 upon 1.75 is nothing but 0.40. Similarly, 1 upon 1.75 will be giving 0.57. Now you have to check that the summation of this should be coming as a 1. If it is not coming unit or 1, then there is some major mistake. Now you can see that 0.43 plus 0.57 is a 1. Now, here one must ask, sir, why you have done summation of stiffness over here only, not the all? Because if you are taking one joint only, so we have to sum up that particular joint member's summation, stiffness summation. So for that particular point only, we have to find that particular stiffness. So this is a stiffness of BA member and this is a stiffness of BC member. Now moving ahead, now there is no other central joint. Now we are left with the external joint only. So take one by one. I have taken as a. Now you can see A is a simple support or hinge support. So for that hinge support, distribution factor is 1. So I have placed as a 1. Similarly for C as a 1. So this is the way you can find this distribution factor which we'll be using ahead. So our first step was to find fixed end moment, and then our second step is to find distribution factor. Now let's move to the third step. Now this is nothing but I have took a reference from previous page. This is fixed end moment and this is distribution factor. I have took just for reference because we have to use the values of this both in this table. Now our third step is moment distribution table. So in moment distribution table, it is little difficult to solve, means it is little tricky. Now you have to make a focus how to solve it. Now how many number of supports are there? 1, 2 and 3. So I made 1, 2 and 3 number of column. And how many spans are there? A to B and B to C. Look, A to B and B to C. So now our first table in which we have to write a distribution factor value which we have found out in previous step. So how to write the value? Let's see. Here it is an A point, here it is an C point. So place 1 and 1 as its respective value. Now next, here it is a B member. Now we have two values for B member. Now you can see that here it is going B to A and here it is going B to C. So here the value will be of BA member. So what is the value of BA member is 0.43. So place 0.43 over here. Now 0.57 is of member BC. So I have placed it 0.57. So this was the first line of moment distribution table we have to keep as a distribution factor. Now next line we have to place FEM. Which FEM will come where? Let's see. Now here A point is going towards B. So here will be MAB. Now this B point going towards C means this is the zone of AB's span. So here will be MAB, MFAB. Here it will be MFBA. Minus 20 and plus 20. Look. Here it is the value of MFBC and here should be value of MFCB. Minus 60 and plus 60. So with the help of these two step, means step number one and step number two, we can place the value of all in this moment distribution table. Now further we have to solve this table. Now, how to solve? Let's see. Now look, here you can see it is a simple support. So we know that simple support does not resist moment, but here as per FEM it is coming minus 20. So we have to make it as zero because simple support does not resist moment. So we have to make as a zero because it does not resist moment. So how do we make it? Let's see. Now here it is given minus 20. Change its sign, means convert into opposite sign, means we have converted into 20. Then 20 multiplied by 1 is nothing but 20. So I have placed over here. Similarly, C support is also a simple support, but here also moment is given. Now here we'll solve further. Look, minus 60 means 60 was given, change its sign, minus 60 multiply by 1 is coming minus 60. Now we have to send half of moment to the center support. Now in our first page we have seen that consider a central support as a fixed support, means here if it is a simple support and it is a center of the both support, then we have to consider it as a fixed support. So it can resist moment. Half of moment will be transferred at the center, means half of 20 is nothing but 10, half of minus 60 is nothing but minus 30. So we have done balance A and C and carry over to the B, means we have balanced A and C and carry over to the point B. Now these are remarks. What we did, first distribution factor, then FEM, and then we did balance A and C and carry over to B. So you have to write all this. Now our next step will be initial moment, means here you can see the simple support, we have to make it as a zero. Now add or sum of these two values, minus 20 plus 20 will be coming zero, 60 and minus 60 will be coming zero, means we have done that it is a simple support, so there will be no moment, so zero and zero. Now 20 plus 10 is nothing but 30, minus 60 minus 30 is nothing but minus 90. Now I have made an underline over here. Let's see how to solve this. Now this entire line is nothing but my initial moment, because I have made over simple support as a 0, 0 moment and I have found out some moment at the for center support. Now we have to solve this. Now how to solve? Let's see. Similarly, which we did over here, we will be doing over here. Means algebraic sum of these two moment. Here we didn't done algebraic sum, but we have to do here algebraic sum. Means 30 minus 90 is nothing but minus 60. Now sign change, means plus 60 and that multiply with 0.43 and 0.57, means 60 multiplied by 0.43 is nothing but 25.71 and 60 multiplied by 0.57, which is over here, is 34.28. So I am getting this value, and 0 multiplied by 1 is nothing but 0 and 0 multiplied by 1 is nothing but my 0. So we have balanced the moment. Now I would like to repeat what we did. First, we have made this two as a zero, means we have used this and then converted its sign, multiplied by with this, kept over here and half transfer. The same over here. Now we just add up to come over here, means this all values and consider it as an initial moment. Now we have to solve this, means 30 minus 90, algebraic sum is minus 60. Then we have to convert the sign for as a rule of moment distribution method, so plus 60 and then multiplied with 0.43 to get this 25 value and multiplied with 0.57 to get this 34.28 value. Now 0 multiplied by 1 is nothing but 0 and 0 multiplied by 1 is nothing but 0. Now we have found out this value. Now at last we have to find the end moments. So how to find? Let's check out. Just sum up these two values. 0 plus 0 is nothing but 0. 30 plus 25.71 is nothing but 55.71. minus 90 plus 34 will be giving minus 55.71. 0 plus 0 is nothing but 0. So these are my final moments. Now, how to check our final moments are correct or not? Let's see. Simple support does not resist moment, so 0, 0. It is also simple support. So the algebraic sum of the moment should be equal to 0. The same rule applicable as per slope deflection, that in central span, if it is a simple support, if the central support is a simple support, the algebraic sum of moment should be equal to 0. So now here you can see plus 55 and minus 55. Ultimately it is 0. So our sum is, or our moment distribution value are correct. Now move ahead. If your these two values are not coming same, then we have to repeat this entire process for further. This will be look at further sums. How to repeat this process? Now our next step is final moment. So these are my final moments. Placed it as MAB, MBA, MBC, and MCB. So these are my final moments. And at last, we have to draw bending moment diagram. Here it was a point load. Here it was a UDL. You can see here. UDL of 20 and length 6, point load of 40 and length 4. So you have to find a central span moment, which is nothing but for point load WL by 4, values is 40, and for UDL it is WL square by 8, values 90. This is a similar which we using in slope deflection. So just made a triangle for point load and curve for UDL. Now what about this? Now here you can see here it is 0, so 0. Here it is also 0, so 0. But here right side positive, so plus. And for if you are considering BC span, so for BC span left side is negative, so up. So ultimately connect this. This is our sum done. So let's have a quick revision that we first did fixed end moment, then we did distribution factor table, then we moment distribution table, and then draw SFD and BMD. But here we have only asked BMD, so we will have the BMD only. We did fixed end moment, we did distribution factor table. Then we did moment distribution table, then final moments from this line, and then bending moment diagram. That's it.